So as we know, this past Monday, Congress finally came to an agreement on some sort of stimulus package, $900 billion package, but the American people are only going to be receiving stimulus checks of about $600 per adult. And President Trump had a lot to say about this, and we're gonna get right into that because President Trump has hinted at possibly vetoing this stimulus package, which $600 is change to the American people right now. And I totally am in agreement with Donald Trump not wanting to sign this bill because it is 5,593 pages of BS. Of BS. Of all this extra stuff attached to it, which Congress, that is a tactic that they often use where they attach a bunch of bull crap that has nothing to do with the issue at hand. And the issue at hand is the American people are suffering. I'm gonna go ahead and play the video where Donald Trump spoke about this bill. And on a side note, we need to start adding term limits to these US senators, House representatives, even the vice president. All these people do not have term limits, and we need to push as the American people to create some term limits for these corrupt politicians, because that is what they are. They are living rich as they been have, and we as the American people, we are suffering due to their policies, due to their backdoor deals, due to all of their self-serving agendas. And make sure you follow me on Parler and on Rumble. I post there frequently on both, and we gotta get right into this one.
Throughout the summer, Democrats cruelly blocked COVID relief legislation in an effort to advance their extreme left-wing agenda and influence
Nancy Pelosi
the election. Then, a few months ago, Congress started negotiations on a new package to get urgently needed help to the American people. It's taken forever. However, the bill they are now planning to send back to my desk is much different than anticipated. It really is a disgrace. For example, among the more than 5,000 pages in this bill, which nobody in Congress has read because of its length and complexity, it's called the COVID Relief Bill, but it has almost nothing to do with COVID. This bill contains $85.5 million for assistance to Cambodia, $134 million to Burma, $1.3 billion for Egypt and the Egyptian military, which will go out and buy almost exclusively Russian military equipment, $25 million for democracy and gender programs in Pakistan, $505 million to Belize, Costa Rica, El Salvador, Guatemala, Honduras, Nicaragua, and Panama, $40 million for the Kennedy Center in Washington, D.C., which is not even open for business, $1 billion for the Smithsonian, and an additional $154 million for the National Gallery of Art. Likewise, these facilities are essentially not open. $7 million for reef fish management, $25 million to combat Asian carp, $2.5 million to count the number of amberjack fish in the Gulf of Mexico, a provision to promote the breeding of fish in federal hatcheries, $3 million in poultry production technology, $2 million to research the impact of down trees, $566 million for construction projects at the FBI. The bill also allows stimulus checks for the family members of illegal aliens, allowing them to get up to $1,800 each. This is far.
Which is, that was the first point of contention when they originally were trying to make the second stimulus bill.
More than the Americans are given. Despite all of this wasteful spending and much more, the $900 billion package provides hardworking taxpayers with only $600 each in relief payments. And not enough money is given to small businesses, and in particular restaurants, whose owners have suffered so grievously. They were only given a deduction for others to use in business their restaurant for 2 years. This 2-year period must be withdrawn, which will allow the owners to obtain financing and get their restaurants back in condition. Congress can terminate it at a much later date, but 2 years is not acceptable. It's not enough. Congress found plenty of money for foreign countries, lobbyists, and special interests while sending the bare minimum to the American people who need it. It wasn't their fault. It was China's fault, not their fault.
Right.
I am asking Congress to amend this bill and increase the ridiculously low $600 to $2,000 or $4,000 for a couple. I'm also asking Congress to immediately get rid of the wasteful and unnecessary items from this legislation and to send me a suitable bill, or else the next administration will have to deliver a COVID relief package, and maybe that administration will be me, and we will get it done. Thank you very much.
We heard what the president said. He said that, hey, I am not even going to sign this the way that it is. That's what he's strongly hinting at that. He didn't say that he would outright veto it, but he's strongly hinting at, you need to bring me something more suitable for the American people, which I agree, because I am sick and tired of these lifelong politicians always getting their paycheck. They remain paid regardless of what is going on in society. And with the previous government shutdowns that we've had, Congress still gets paid. So they have never missed a check. They have never missed their pay. And see, what they're supposed to be paid, that is actually far from what they actually get paid, because they get anonymous donors, anonymous investors, all that stuff. Once we allowed money really into politics, this is what we have today. We have Maxine Waters living in a $6 million mansion outside of her district. We have all these politicians that are very, very well off financially, and sometimes we don't even know where the money comes from. And this includes Joe Biden. We don't know where the money comes from.